Welcome back, guys, for another video. In today's video, I'm going to be going over a beginner stitch, which is a puff stitch. But this is work just slightly different than your usual puff stitch scarf. And I think it's easy enough for beginners, and it's fun enough for more advanced crocheters. But I'm going to be going a little slower in this tutorial. So for beginners, you'll be able to grab your hook and yarn and follow along. So that's exactly what I need you to do. Grab your hook. And this is kind of a mystery hook I've been using all week. I'm not sure the size. I think it might be a 5.5. I don't know. Me and my dad were playing around in wood shop, and actually it came out neat. And I never really used it, and now I can't stop. So I think 5.5. And then worsted weight. This is a cascade that was provided by Never Enough Yarn. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a slip knot. And there are several ways of doing a slip knot. I'll show you two, but basically make a loop just like that. And then bring this piece underneath and then grab with your hook. And then just pull both ends like that, and then pull the shorter end, and you have your slip knot. And then my way, I use the hook, and I don't know if I can get it slow enough to show you guys. So go around, basically pull through like you're doing a stitch, yarn over, and then pull through. That's it. That's the way I do it. I don't know why. But, so what we're gonna do, before we get started, please, no comments on my mangled cuticles. I'm trying a new nail strengthener, and it's like, seriously messing with my cuticles. So trying to stare at them. So we're going to chain 20, okay? So now that you have your slip knot, yarn over, pull through, one, yarn over, pull through, two, yarn over, pull through, three, yarn over, pull through, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I almost did that in my mom's accent, but I didn't because she'd be like, "Jenny, don't make fun of my English. I love you, Mom." Okay, so now we have our 20 chains, okay? And let me know if this light's too bright. I just want to make sure you guys can see the stitches. So we are going to go in to the fourth chain from the hook. So we don't count this. Never do. We count one, two, three, four. And then we do our first puff stitch into the fourth chain. So we're going to yarn over, go into that chain, yarn over, pull up a loop. So you have three. Yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull up a loop. So we have one, two, three, four, five. Yarn over, go back in to the same stitch, pull up a loop. So now we have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, yarn over, we'll go back in. It feels awkward for the first row. It's because it is. Okay, see all these? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Okay, so we've got all of these, yarn over, and we're going to pull through all but the last one, and it's gonna get wiggly. Actually, this hook might not have been great with this yarn. Okay, so pull up until the last one. Okay, don't pull through the last one. Yarn over, pull through two, chain to secure, and then chain one more. Okay, seems like a lot, but once you get the hang of it, it is super easy. So basically, we're going to be going in, I think it's four times, to get the nine loops, secure it, we'll pull through, okay, then pull through two, and then chain two. That's pretty much it. So yarn over, and we're gonna skip the next stitch, which is this, and go into this one and do the exact same thing. Now usually I go in through both loops, but not now, because doing a scarf, it'll make this bottom row really tight. So we went in, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, go back in, pull up a loop, yarn over, go back in, pull up a loop. Let's count, see how many we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yarn over, go back in, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through all of them but the last. No! Sorry. Okay, and then yarn over, pull through the last two. This yarn might not be the greatest, it's kind of splitting. And then chain two. The chain one's to kind of lock your puff, and then chain another to move over. So those are two puffs. Let me grab some yarn. If you use yarns like Karen Simply Soft or, you know, any kind of yarn that's like this, kind of splits, it's going to be a little harder with a puff stitch. I go with like a sport yarn, like that, or baby yarn, or I love this yarn, that does really well. It does well with anything. Alright, skip your next stitch, work your puff into the following. So yarn over, pull up loop, yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull up a loop. Let's see how many we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so yarn over, I already did, pull through all except for the last one, yarn over, pull through the last two, chain two. Okay, so we've got our three. Okay, do it again with you. Always just yarn over. Skip the next one. Go into the next chain. Yarn over, pull up a loop. 1, 2, 3, 4 times. When you do it four times, you're always going to have nine. And then pull through, yarn over, pull through your last two, chain one, two. Okay, come back down, skip your next chain, go into the next, yarn over, okay, pull up a loop, so that's one, two, three, four. Yarn over, pull through all, except for the last one. Yarn over, pull through two, one, and two. Okay, we just have a few more. Yarn over, come down, skip that one. One, two, three, 4, yarn over, pull through 8 of them. Gotta kind of wiggle it through sometimes. No, not again. Alright. Chain 2. This yarn is so soft. Wish you could feel it. Come back down, skip 1. Yarn over. And do your puff stitch. 1. 2. Over, pull through 8. You guys should see how I'm doing this. I have my camera in my lap. I'm sitting on the floor. 1, 2. Now it's on the side of my face. Move that. Sorry about that. Okay. All right. Yarn over. Come back down. Skip 1. Go into the next. Work your puff. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yarn over. Pull through 8. Pull through 2. And then chain 1, 2. Okay. And then we come down. We skip this one and go into our very last one and work a puff. 1, 2, 3. Getting kind of sloppy on there. Okay, pull through. And that last one's going to be a little tight. All right, now here we're going to chain 3. At the end of our row, we're going to chain 3. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, now turn your work. Now, this is what we have so far. Okay, now you have 2 options. The way I've been doing it, and I think it looks nice, is, let me find it, working in the spaces in upside down. So normally you would do your puff stitch in the top of a puff stitch. I've been doing it in the spaces just because I like it. I like the staggered look. But it's up to you. You can do either. Oops. You can do either way. Okay. So once we do the chain 3, instead of going in where we normally would, we're just going to go into the space. So yarn over, go into the first space. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yarn over, pull through 8. Yarn over, pull through 2. Chain 1. Yarn over, go into your next chain space. Pull up a loop. That was 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Chain 1. Wait a minute. Did I chain 1 or 2? Chain 2. Chain 1. So coming back up, yarn over, go back into your next available space or hole. Yarn over. Once. Twice. 3 times. 4 times. Now, some people tell you to like pull up each stitch level, and I don't do that. I like tighter, neater little puff stitches, which once I'm in a rhythm and the camera's not in my lap, they actually do come out pretty nice and tidy. Now I was talking, running my yip yap. Oh no. This yarn splits a lot. Yarn over, go into your next. I'm not going to talk during this one because I distract myself. Ooh, focus, buddy. Wow. Yarn over. One, two, three, four. Yarn over. Pull through all of them, but the last one. Yarn over. Pull through two. Chain one. Two. Yeah, I think I forgot to do the chain two right here. Oh well. Go into the next space. One, two, three, four. Chain two. Okay, yarn over. Next space. Two. Three, four, yarn over, go through eight, yarn over, go through two, chain two, yarn over, one, two, three, four, yarn over. Go through eight, yarn over, go through two, and then chain one and two. Yarn over, go into the next space. One, two, three, four. Chain two. Okay, now here, that space. This is the most crucial part of the whole pattern. Simple pattern. Just always remembering to get into your chain spaces from the row below. So these are the four that we skipped at the beginning of our pattern. So we want to go in there and work a puff. So one, two, three, four. And we want to do that every single row. Make sure. Two, three. Make sure you're working into this last chain three space. Always, always, always put a puff. Okay? And you always chain up three. So that's basically it. And you can kind of give it a pull so you can see and get an idea. If you want them tighter together, you can drop down a hook size. If you don't want any spaces at all, you could just work into the top of the puff. But yeah, so that is pretty much it. You're just going to keep repeating row two until you have it as long as you would like. And it'll start to look like this. This is a think baby weight. It's like Bernat. But so we're down here on row two and just repeat row two until you have the length that you want. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys have any comments or questions or ideas for videos, feel free to comment below. All right, you guys, take care. Bye.